Blair France and her family have a problem. She and her husband and their three kids live in social housing here in Calgary. And France says her kids are being bullied and antagonized and beaten up by other neighborhood kids. And the reason why might surprise you. Blair France joins us now to pick up the story. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you today?
Well, I'm fine. How are you? What's happening in your neighborhood?
We could be better. We have a bullying issue in our neighborhood here.
Describe it for me. What's going on?
We have children that are constantly bullying our family, throwing rocks and et cetera things at our house, almost hitting me and my 7-month-old son with rocks, bullying my children at school and at home every single day. We also have these children, when they bully my children, there's hundreds of them that come up on our lawn and bully us and throw rocks and stuff at us, swear at us and everything. We have tried to talk to parents in the area and nothing seems to be done.
Hundreds of kids on your lawn. What's behind the bullying? What's the source of it, do you think?
I'm not a racial person, but I think it's a racial issue here. I think it's because we're a white family and our community is mostly immigrants.
Immigrants from where?
Mostly, I think Africa, and most of them are Somalian as well and Muslim.
How long has this been going on?
I heard from sources around the area that it's been going on for over 10 years.
Oh, okay. So you're saying you're not the only family?
I'm not the only family,
okay.
No.
Did this start right away when you moved in, or has it escalated?
No, when we first moved in, it was winter, so no kids would go outside. My children would play outside because they don't mind being cold. But once it started to warm up, that's when all the children would come out and they fight constantly. Hit each other with shoes. I have videos. I have evidence of them putting marks on my children. I've called the police numerous times. Our last situation here was to make an anti-bullying event at our house this weekend.
Mm-hmm. And we'll hear more about that. But I'm curious still what's behind this. I'm sure some people listening saying, well, can you move? What's your situation?
Well, I called Calgary Housing about moving because that's where we live, is in Calgary Housing. Now, when I asked for them to move us, they say that they don't have the funds to transfer us.
I see. So you're in a social housing complex, and you have any options in terms of where you can go, or do you just get to go where they put you?
I don't have options on where to go. Like, if I refuse on moving into where they gave me a house, then I would still have to wait even longer. Hmm. And the situation we were in before was really dire. We needed this place more than anything.
What impact is this having on your kids?
My kids, it's affected them in many, many ways. My children's grades have gone down in school. They've never been bullied before. We came from Forest Lawn, which I know is a rougher area, but in Forest Lawn, we've never had an issue like this.
You mentioned you tried reaching out to your neighbors, talking to the parents of the other kids. What's that been like?
I have talked to numerous parents. Some parents are really good. They will discipline their children. They'll get them children to come in the house, and they will do whatever they do to discipline their children, which I respect that. And there was another woman on Sunday. I went and I talked to her about her children bullying my children. She came at me with her fist, swearing and stuff at me in front of all the children that were waiting to go to church, as well as my own.
You tell me this is racially motivated. Why do you think that?
Because the people in this area, they keep on telling us to move. They call us white crackers. They say that we're poor. They're always saying something about the color of our skin and stuff like that, too. And I know, you know, when people are mad, they say some really mean things. Right? But that doesn't give people the right to talk the way that they do, right?
Right. You mentioned you're going to have an anti-bullying barbecue event this weekend in your community.
Yes.
Who do you hope shows up, and what are you hoping to accomplish?
Well, I know I do have Bodyguards, which is an organization that will be coming and supporting us for this event. They are an organization that deal with bullied children. They also deal with the bullies, because bullies get bullied too. That's why they bully. So we're having them here to try and figure out the situation and to figure out ways to make this better. Also, we are doing a fundraiser for the children in this area to get recreational items for the kids to play with. We need a new basketball court here. The park needs to be fixed and cleaned up, and recreational balls and stuff, you know, for the kids to play with so they're not fighting with each other.
It sounds like you don't want to move. You just want to find peace with your neighbors. Am I right?
Yes, I do. I can't move. I pay $370 to live where I am, okay? That's not much money to live where I am. No, it's not. But I don't make much money. I am on social assistance. My husband works a part-time job. And we don't make enough money to pay $1,400 plus utilities, right? We barely make enough money to live where we are right now. So we have no choice but to stay where we're at. Calgary Housing won't move us, so we can't move. We're stuck.
Blair, I look forward to hearing how your barbecue goes this weekend, and I want to thank you very much for joining us to tell us about your story.
Thank you very much for listening. I needed somebody to listen, one person to listen, and everybody will hear.